In this lesson, we'll talk about how to configure one of the redundancy protocols, HSRP, in Packet Tracer. HSRP is a Cisco-specific network redundancy protocol. You can only use HSRP in Cisco devices. For our HSRP configuration example, we'll use the topology on the screen, and as you can see, the IP configurations has already done. In our HSRP configuration, we'll configure a virtual IP for router 0 and router 1. As you can see, they have already physical addresses, and beside this, they will configured with an virtual IP addresses. And one of these routers will be selected as active, and the other will be selected as standby. And the traffic from PC0 to PC2 will go through the active one. And if the link between this active part down, and then the traffic will go through the standby. And here the active and standby selection is made according to the priority values. And in our configuration, we will manipulate these priority values. Now we can start our HSRP configuration on router 0. As you can see, the standby selection. We'll select standby 1 first. And this is our standby IP address, the virtual IP address. And our priority, the default one is 100, and here we can select 150 as priority. And the preemption. We need this preemption because of after the failure, when the standby become active, and then again the link become online again, then if the preempt option is selected like this, then it can be active again. Yes, let's do the other parts of the HSRP configuration on router 1. Yes, we cannot give any priority, then it is remain as default to 100. Yes. Here we also need to give a gateway IP address to the PC. And this gateway IP address will be the IP address of the HSRP, the virtual IP address. Yes. And now let's also configure the other redundancy mechanism from right to left, from PC2 to PC0. And our standby is 2 now. And our virtual IP address again. And preemption. And now for the other ends, I will left here with the default priority value, and it is 100. and here I will manipulate the priority value, and this time this will be the active one. For the first configuration, the active one will be here, the router 0, and for the other end, the active one will be router 1. Yes, we will also give the PC to address of the virtual IP address as a gateway. Yes, it's okay. Now let's verify our configuration. As you can see, the ping is successful from PC0 to PC2, and we can trace from here to the other end again. And as you can see, our way is going through the router 0. Firstly, it's going router 0 and then going to the PC2. This is our host. As you can see, 10.0.0.2 is the interface IP address of the router 0, and this IP address is also for PC2. And let's do this from the other end. First, let's ping our PC. As you can see, it is pinging. And here, as you can see, our traffic is going first router 0 and then our PC 0. According to our configuration, our traffic must be go through router 1, but this trace is showing that it's going through router 0. After a little investigation period, I realized that we cannot change the priority value in packet tracer. I think it is missing in packet tracer. Because as you can see, our configured priority values is not set here, because as you remember, I gave this priority as 150 and here it was default. And we can also check here, our priority value is 100 and the other is also 100. They are all in default values, and as you remember, I gave one of them firstly 120 and then I changed it to 150. So it didn't accept this configuration. And after the reload of this two router, the active one become standby and the other standby become active again. And let's check this also here. As you can see, from PC0, if I ping PC2, firstly I'm going through the router 1 and then going to the PC2. So this is the active way, and we can also check from here. As you can see, on router 1, the fast Ethernet 0 is active one, and here is active, and the router 0's fast Ethernet 0.0 is now in standby mode, so the traffic is coming here and go through here. And for the left side, as you can see. Here and the facet element 01 is standby, and for router 0's facet element 01 is active. So from PC2, if I ping PC0, the traffic will come through here. Let's try one more time. As you can see, traffic is coming here 20.002 and then going through PC0, and here let's delete one of the link here, the link between the switch and the router one, and then for the first group the active router one will be standby anymore, and active one will be router zero. This active standby will change. So let's try this, and as you can see, there are some HSRP state changes here and also here. It says that facet element 00 is now active, and also the down alarm came to here, and our traffic will be go through this way, and let's check this from PC0, and now as you can see, before our traffic was going through the router 1, but now it's going through router 0, so our redundancy configuration is okay now. You can also check another interface status, and according to this status you can decrease your priority value. Your priority value can decrease 10 by 10 by this way. I will not configure a track here, but I will show how to do it. In standby, as you can see, there's a track here, and you will give the interface address here that you want to control, and if that interface go down, then your priority will decrease, and according to this status, your standby, your active router can be standby like this. This is for only checking another interface. In this HSRP example, we tried to configure two HSRP group 1 and group 2, and according to this group we create a virtual IP address for each group, and traffic from PC0 to PC2 go through the active one according to this HSRP configuration. And again, from PC2 to PC0, the traffic go through the another way, through the another active one. And for this video, it's okay. And in the following videos, we'll see redundancy protocols more.